So in other words, the two of you might still be together? He gaped at me. Still? What do you mean? Well, not really. But there was never a decisive break, that's what I mean. No. He had met Bodil in Torgalmenningen in town. It had been July. He had a summer job at Hansa Brewery, but was on the evening shift that day, and she was alone in Bergen. He could see it now. She was wearing a short, stone-washed denim skirt, white blouse, so flimsy that the flower pattern of her bra was visible through it. After a long, rainy July, the sun had finally broken through the clouds, and the rays reflected on her blonde hair and dazzled him. She was laughing. Was that perhaps the reason why? So you and Berit aren't together anymore, is that right? Doesn't seem so. Spontaneously, she had reached out to him and kissed him on the cheek. Oh, we'll have to celebrate this then. Do you want to come with me? Home? He did. They had sat in the garden in Sudmansvei, drinking white wine from tall glasses, and she had smiled and laughed at everything he said. With a mischievous smirk, she had taken off her blouse, then encouraged him to do the same, caressed his chest, and looked at him with that strange, compelling gaze that turned him to butter that melted in the sun. They had gone into the big house, to where it was cool, up under the roof, stylishly furnished, and with polished woodwork. In her parents' bed, "Mine is so narrow," she had said, undoing her skirt from the side. They had made love without inhibition, and with an intensity so febrile that his memories of Berit paled from Congress to Congress, the first, second, third.